Two other things. As soon as I said that, the team remembered that we are recording today. Perfect. So I think two quick announcements. One is that we have set up a community of finance professionals. Most of the finance professionals currently are based here in the UAE in Dubai, but there are other people joining from other parts of the world as well. We are creating this community in order to pass on thought leadership. We do various events so that you can network with each other. It's a great way for you to build your personal brand because some of you can become speakers in future events. And Jeff and my colleague, towards the end of this webinar, will be sending a link which you can use to join this community. And the only other thing is that feel free during the discussion when we call out to ask questions, even by unmuting yourself. There's a reason we don't do this as a webinar rather than a meeting, because we want to interact with you. But during the talk, during the presentation, do stay on mute. If there is anything that you'd like, just raise your hands. If your video is on your actual hand, if your video is not on your virtual hand using the Zoom feature, and we will call out to you and ask you to unmute and ask your question as well. So that's about it from me. I'm really, really looking forward to learning more about CPM systems. So over to you, Evgeny and Alexey. Looking forward to today's talk.
Thank you very much, Varun.
Thank you,
I
Varun.
Hope everybody hear me. Yes, thank you very much. So I will start screen sharing. Just a second. I hope you see my screen now. Yes, okay, thank you very much. So today's presentation is brought to you by Consolidon Network and AD Professional Solutions, which I represent here. AD is a company specialized in systems integration and finance methodology. So welcome all of you. And today we will be somehow following the article that we have earlier published at LinkedIn and our corporate site, and the links we shall be providing a little bit later in our presentation. I am planning to take around 3/4 of an hour for our presentation, and welcome once again, and let's get started. So in the beginning, I shall briefly tell you about the content of today's meeting. First of all, I will briefly introduce myself and Alexey, and we'll tell a few words about ADE. Then we will move on to the tasks of finance departments and systems that we are using to automate them. It will be just a brief recap. Then we shall tell you about the CPM systems, what they are, what applications they automate, and discuss why Excel still rules in this area. And but still, we shall discuss the advantages of moving to CPM, and finally move on to the competitive landscape of the CPM systems. And a little bit later, Alexey will tell us about the differences between CPM and BI systems. So let's move on. My name is Evgeny Rudakov. I'm a partner at AD Professional Solutions. I'm working for AD Professional Solutions already for 17 years. And as a partner at AD Professional Solutions, I'm leading our systems integration department and leading the projects at our major clients. We have almost 25 finished completed projects at the finance automation, at the consolidation, business planning, and all related areas. And I will give a few minutes to Alexei to introduce himself. Alexei, please.
Yes, yeah, now I am mute. Hello, everyone. Yeah, my name is Alexei. I have more than 20 years of hands-on experience in IT up to around 2015. I was mainly involved in IRP implementation of some leading vendors. Now I'm more focused on CPM or EM and BI systems. By now I'm a certified professional in platforms like Microsoft Power BI, IBM Planning Analytics, Anaplan. Not only them indeed, but these are the most known, I guess. I'm also trying to write a blog. It's exploredata.pro, as you can see. My focus is practice and less marketing. So everyone is very welcome here. Thank you. Back to Evgeny.
Okay, thank you, Alexei. So a couple of words about ADE. Our company, ADE Professional Solutions, we have started our operations in 2004. So, and we serve clients in more than 20 countries. We have now offices in Russia and the United Arab Emirates. And from Emirates, we provide services to of automation and finance together with the Consolidon Group, working in Gulf countries. In Russia, we are number second in the field of IFRS accounting. And have more than 1,000 financial statements issued. We have a team of more than 50 certified professionals. They're certified as CCAs, CFAs, and have many specific IT product certifications. And our key strength, I would say, is that we can have a cross-functional team of specialists able to engage in complex IT implementations. So let's move to the discussing main tasks of the financial department. I'm very much aware that we are all aware of the functions of the finance department. However, I would like to recap in short some of their functions. First of all, it's financial accounting and reporting, which means recording accounting transactions, also preparation of the financial statements and presenting them to relevant stakeholders such as shareholders, tax authorities, and also I would also mention audit support until the auditors sign off on the financial statements. Our area of the major interest is budgeting and planning, which includes developing budgets for the next periods. It could be strategic budgets or it could be the operational budgets, analyzing and forecasting financial outcomes from the actual data, and defining key financial objectives and also divisioning strategies. Also, another area is financial analysis, which means assessing financial results and performance indications of the companies, such as liquidity, profitability, and solvency, identifying trends and understanding the reasons behind changes in financial indicators and in dynamics. Also here we mention liquidity management, which means managing the company's liquidity by assessing its need in borrowed funds, for example, managing working capitals, optimizing inventory levels, and working with also accounts receivable. Another very important area is tax planning and accounting, because compliance with tax regulation is essential for well-being of each company, as well as, of course, optimization of tax obligation and preparation of accurate declarations and reports. Another area for finance department is risk management, which means defining some risk management strategies, analyzing risk areas, currency risks, interest risks, liquidity risks, etc., and formulating management strategies and implementing appropriate measures to avoid them. Also, here I should mention investment decision justification, which for us, for finance people, means creating some investment models for calculating return on investment and making some viable financial decisions about investments. And finally, financial policy management, which includes formulating and implementing the company's financial strategy and establishing rules and procedures for financial operations. And all these areas which are of interest for the finance departments should somehow be automated. And here I have listed only some types of the software which we use in daily activity. First of all, which is absolutely necessary, is accounting software, which is used for recording transactions, for issuing primary accounting documents, and for also preparing the financial reports. ERP or enterprise resource planning systems have a much wider range of functions, which also includes not only accounting, but also some operational planning, some HR planning, some resource planning, etc. And they have they give you broader view on the financial, and not only financial, but also operational situation in the company. Then we move to the planning and budgeting systems. These are specifically the systems that are of interest for us. They are called corporate, or earlier they were called enterprise performance management systems. And in short, this means CPM and EPM systems. CPM systems represent the software for developing and controlling company's budget, modeling and analyzing financial data, forecasting results, evaluating impact on strategic decisions, and company's financial status. Another software that will be in short discussed today is business intelligence, or BI systems. I would define them as the systems for analyzing financial information collected from various sources and presented in some graphical or tabular form, but Alexey will give better definition of this and also discuss how they differ from CPM systems. Another type of system that is usually used by finance departments is asset management systems. These asset management systems usually are used for not for accounting, but also for tracking the company's fixed or intangible, for example, assets, determining their value, calculating depreciation, and also might be for tracking their condition and the need for repairs. Another systems are risk management systems, which are used for documenting risks and for providing a needed strategy for eliminating them. Also, the side systems are electronic document management and data storage, which ensure electronic storage and secure exchange of documents between companies or people within companies. And there are also many types of other systems, primarily with more specialized purposes. For example, this could be invoicing systems and the payment processing systems. It could be systems of automation or specific accounting areas that require specific processes or algorithms. As an example, I will give, for example, the systems for lease accounting under IFRS 16, because for me it's a very interesting subject, and it's also very difficult subjects for systems and very specific for it. Specific systems might be required. So let's move on to CPM systems, which are subjects of today's discussion. CPM systems are used to provide to integrated approach to planning, budgeting, analysis, forecasting, reporting, and risk management. So for most of the areas that we have discussed. The standardization of this class of systems is somehow artificial because they have grown from the type of databases which are called OLAP. This is somehow this is some type of specific architecture of databases called OLAP or online analytical processing. And with the development of this type of databases, it became this synonymous of CPM systems, and some people even call CPM systems OLAP systems. The pioneer that managed to stand out from the rest of the systems with this OLAP approach or architecture, in my point of view, is IBM Cognos TM1. And later it has been followed by SAP BPC and Oracle Hyperion. And now it still exists under the name IBM Planning and Analytics. The distinguishing feature of CPM systems is uploading the entire data model into the random access memory or RAM with subsequent processing them, allowing calculation to be performed in seconds or in minutes instead of hours. And multidimensional structures, which can be calculated in the OLAP systems, are particularly suitable for financial analysis, where data needs to be analyzed as presented in this cube simultaneously in multiple dimensions. These dimensions or perspectives can be, for example, sales channels, product categories, versions, for example, version budget versus actual, geographical segments, and so on. And these multidimensional data structures are commonly referred to as multidimensional cubes. The functionality of CPM or OLAP systems can be applied to automation of the such tasks as planning and budgeting, where we can calculate budgets, forecasts, operational plans, also in forecasting and modeling, building financial models, and analysis and reporting, where they're very much suitable for aggregating and consolidating financial information across companies, segments, products, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So the functional applications of CPM systems also, besides functional applications, CPM systems have also the applications in different departments of the organization. These departments can be, for example, sales and marketing, inventory, etc. And this approach where CPM systems are used for various departments within an organization has emerged not very recently. I think it has been on the market around 5 or 6 years. And the organization that pioneered this approach called connected planning was the company called Anaplan. And this approach aims to enable a collaboration across multiple departments in the same system. Because before, the only beneficiary of the CPM systems was finance department, but now all the departments can collaborate in the same system. But for us, for finance people, it's still more beneficial because we can see the data that entered in the system by different functions. So let's go to the functions. First of all, it's sales and marketing, because for sales, it has been always very important to plan in some type of system. So sales can forecast, plan marketing activities in the system, analyze sales performance, and budget marketing expenses for them. Also, another function in the organization that can apply for CPM systems is inventory and production management, where inventory planning is available in the system, supply planning, production resource management, forecasting of production volumes and resource allocation. And for us, of course, in terms of inventory and production management, the very important application of CPM systems is allocation, which allows us to derive to the final financial result from each product produced by the company. Another area in the organization that can be also covered by CPM system is HR. Because HR has many resources involved into workforce planning, into hiring management, into termination management. They should calculate personnel costs. They should calculate costs for training and development, and as well as the most complicated area for HR is compensation and rewards planning. Especially this is important for salespeople. Another area that is emerging in CPM systems is operational planning, because before it was absolutely impossible to move operational planning into a CPM system because of the lack of computational power, but now it's possible. And so operational planning is available in CPM systems. They can assist in managing operational expenses, resources, forecasting operational results, and improve efficiency of operational processes. Another very important area is procurement and logistics. For planning supplies, logistics, optimizing supply chain, forecasting demand, and planning inventory levels. And for example, in procurement and logistics, the discrete optimization mechanisms are very important that can be also found in modern CPM systems. And another last but not least area is IT planning and infrastructure, where IT can plan its resources, budget IT projects, which become more and more expensive, and define IT strategy. But still, excel rules in financial planning and analysis area. And here I try to understand why. The competition on CPM market is very, very high, but still they cannot cope with Excel because of the following factors. First of all, it's Excel provides simple and flexible interface, which is commonly known to many finance specialists. They can easily build custom models that reflect the unique needs of, and characteristics of the company. The finance people have experience of working with Excel. It's, I would say, prerequisite for hiring any financial specialist. So they are well acquainted with the, its functions, and it allows them to quickly adopt and use Excel as their primary tool. Excel has also wide data analysis capabilities. It offers powerful data analysis features, formulas, also pivot tables, charts, graphs, and it allows to visualize and interpret data with a high degree of flexibility. And finally, it's very important, it's accessibility and low cost. Because it comes usually pre-installed at almost any computer that is purchased by any organization, and there's no additional cost for licensing and training specialists for working with Excel. So let's move on. However, we have a lot of downsides of Excel that we should also discuss. First of all, it's inability to handle large scale industrial data volumes. Somehow, of course, it can be solved by connection to external databases, but still the speed of processing huge data volumes is quite awful. Then Excel has no actual real multidimensionality. Of course, it has some kind of multidimensionality, which is managed by pivot tables, but still it's not quite full multidimensionality because, for example, if you need to work with various versions, you need to copy manually copy multiple tables. Then data integrity, of course, is a huge problem, especially when you're working with the multiple users. And then can be the conflict of versions and the conflict of data. Security is also a big issue of Excel because it has no actual security apart from password protection, maybe. The lack of built-in workflow functionality. Because workflow in Excel, as we all know, is replaced by exchanging Excel files through emails in most of the companies. Or not even email, but through the messengers, which is also not quite secure. So, after it's being said, let's move to advantages of transitioning to CPM. There's a huge amount of advantages. First of all, this data integration, because CPM consolidates data from various sources and keeps them into a centralized location. And this provides enhancing data consistency and helps to reduce the errors and improves data quality. Then process automation. Process automation means that CPM can automate routine tasks, such as our financial planning and analysis applications that can and forecasting, and also it allows employees to focus on strategic aspects instead of creating separate reports and analytical the panels. Then enhance data control and security. Most of the systems provide various tools for data control, such as, for example, logging the access and many other tools that help to keep data confidential. Also, extended analytical capabilities. I would also group this feature with the improved reporting and data visualization because they somehow come together. And I think that Alexey would argue with me on these two points because the system, of course, provides some possibilities for some analytical capabilities that can be implemented and some reporting and data visualization. But I would say that the most important here, not what they provide, but that after implementation, all the employees in the company must use these capabilities and must use the dashboards they are provided. So they cannot escape the need to use these analytical capabilities and improved visualizations on a daily basis. And this is somehow not works on only on the systems basis, but this is somehow works on the educational basis, which is important for the employees. Then we move to greater scalability. The greater scalability is a feature that is provided by the architecture of CPM systems themselves. Because as I already told, CPM systems consist of multidimensional cubes where, for example, companies of the group or segments of the group of company can be separate dimension. And in order to scale or roll over the system for a new company or a new segment, you simply need to add the segment into the list. And this this defines the scalability of CPM systems. Then enhanced planning and forecasting means that CPM allows the creation of complex models and scenarios that can be further used by any user in the company. Real-time data handling, as I told already, that for in-memory OLAP allows very fast data handling that is that allows to the data to be processed within seconds or even in real time. And of course, better teamwork and collaboration is very important here because modern systems allows almost unlimited number of users to work in the system. And when we implement the connected planning approach, when all the users in the organization can work in the same system, they can you can see the data that they input in real time on the top level of the management. And finally, CPM systems support strategic and tactical decisions by providing integration approach to planning analysis and enabling companies to make informed decision on strategic and also tactical levels. Let's talk about the how we find which system is suitable for us. There are two main reference points defining the trends for evaluation of the CPM systems. These are agencies that can be considered. First of all, I would name the agency Gartner, and the second one is Forrester. These agencies referenced by most software manufacturers, or how we call them, vendors, as the most authoritative and independent sources. Although they have formally their own methodologies, Gartner's methodology, as we see here, is called Magic Quadrant, and Forrester's methodology is called Forrester's Wave. The visual representation and the actual meaning are roughly the same. So what we see here on the x-axis of these quadrants, let's call them so, in the agencies plot the development procedure perspectives of the companies, and they called the completeness of vision in version of Gartner. And in version of Forrester, it's called stronger strategy. So in broad terms, it means the company, the vendors look into the future, how the system should be developed in the next period, or what is coming up next. Then on the y-axis here, Gartner is plotting ability to execute, and the Forrester is plotting stronger current offering. The today's status of the company on this graph. Another research company that I would mention, which is slightly less than Gartner and Forrester, and slightly less well known, is, for example, Nucleus Research. They have a matrix very similar to Gartner's, which is called value matrix. But if you want to broaden understanding of the market, this matrix can also be used. What I would also say that, for example, if some vendor is not included into some matrix of one of the agencies, it might be included into a matrix of another agency because they have slightly different methodology for evaluation of different vendors. So please look at all the possible options. Now we see the slide with the 2022 financial planning and analysis matrix by Gartner. And we see that, for example, in the upper left corner of the coordinate grid, they accumulate the winners, so to say. But the outliers accumulated closer to the origin. These quadrants are usually created annually for a specific set of selected software categories. And not only software categories, but also Gartner creates such quadrants for hardware categories or even for consulting services categories. And the classifications of these quadrants change with market trends and sometimes with the changes of industry leaders, as we will see later on. Now I move to a little bit of our own, vision of how quadrants of Gartner, which we consider to be more authoritative, how it changed over time. So CPM systems, CPM research of CPM systems started in 2005. And then Quadrant has been called simply CPM suits. And here I have plotted the dots for the researches that I have actually found and saved. So I can share them with you later in this presentation. In 2005, when it started, the Quadrant, the main vendors in this Quadrant were IBM, Oracle, and at the top of the quadrants, which are not particularly interesting. Then, as you see, in 2015, the CPM suites quadrant divided by two quadrants, first of which was FCPM, which means financial CPM, and the second one is SCPM, which is strategic CPM. But then this division, I think that it was quite artificial, because then it became to switch to cloud financial close solutions from FCPM perspective and cloud financial planning and analysis solutions. And then in modern times, in 2022, in late 2022, it has been renamed to financial planning software. So where it started there, it all also ended. And cloud SCPM quadrants discontinued. So now we came to the functional division of the Gartner's quadrants. And they also have functional quadrants in areas of sales performance management, supply chain planning systems, which evolved into supply chain planning solutions, and so SNOP systems of differentiation. I'm not quite sure why they call them, and why a group of financial planning software with all these other categories, because in 2000, if I'm not mistaken, in 2019, Anaplan, which has joined this classification, started very aggressive marketing, and the FCP, financial planning and analytics quadrant became a little bit too tight for them. And therefore, they have started to move into various other quadrants. And this has also been defined by the technical development of CPM systems, which, as I told you already, became more, gained more computational power and entered the market of other systems, which has been before populated by some specific systems. For example, sales performance management, which the quadrant which existed since 2012, has been populated by systems which have not been cross-functional with CPM at all. So let's talk about the players on this market. As I told, the market started from the three major players. It was Oracle, which is now called Oracle Fusion, and before it was Oracle Hyperion or HFM. It is SAP Analytics Cloud and IBM Planning and Analytics. Also, there was SAS, but it no longer exists in this quadrant. It is also was Infor, and it also doesn't exist any longer in this quadrant. Another example is Insight Software, which before was called Longview Wolters Kluwer, which is ex Tagetik software, Profix, Board International, which now is one of the leaders, and Planful. Planful was before known under the name of Cost Analytics. Then the companies emerged in 2014, Workday. Workday was before known as Adaptive Insight, then Anaplan, then Jedox, OneStream Software, Vienna Solutions, very interesting software, and the companies emerged just yet are Syntellis and Capion. I don't know much about Syntellis and Capion, but I think these are the niche players. And also what I should mention is that, for example, Nucleus Research also mentions the company called LucaNet, and a few other companies, and they view their view on the rankings of the CPM systems are a little bit different. And I would say the reason for that is that they have their regional view on the players, because some of the players on the market exist on the, for example, North American market mostly, such as OneStream. Some of them are working mostly on the European market, such as Wolters Kluwer. And some are really multinational. Of course, I'm saying about the big three vendors, Oracle, SAP, and IBM. And some of the new vendors, such as Anaplan and some others. What I should also mention is that the systems here that arrived at the market started from the starting from, I would say, 2014. I would call them the new generation systems, and they are characterized by the following parameters. First of all, they are based on the new technologies that allows them to be easier in use, easier in configuration, and easier in maintenance compared to the older vendors' systems. This means that they use the low-code self-servicing implementation and can be implemented without specific programming skills. Another the characteristic is the flexibility of application, which means that they can be used for actually for this various areas in, within the organization. And another their characteristic is integration. Because they have the wider possibilities of integration between different systems, between the data sources, and they can only be integrated within the between the systems with the help of various cloud applications, and also their support for decision making because. Today's CPM systems also have some BI functionality, and it's involving making them to cross with the BI systems because the presentation capabilities of the system become more and more crucial for the companies. And what I would also mention is that the today's systems are also extended with some artificial intelligence and with some discrete optimization applications. With that, I give the word to Alexey, who will give you the short description of differences between CPM and BI systems. Thank you, Alexey.
Okay, guys. So now I see that Evgeny really likes speaking about this topic because it took us a little bit longer than we planned.
I'll try to
speed up as we don't have a lot of time. So, but if I speak too quick, so please let me know. I'll just start speaking a little bit in a slow pace. Okay. As I already mentioned, over the past 8 years, I've been focused on implementing CPI and BI systems from various vendors. These system classes are closely intertwined, but still they are not the same. Just a couple of weeks ago, I started working on a comprehensive article about this topic. Then I found out that my colleagues and one of them, Evgeny, were organizing a webinar, this webinar, on a similar subject, and asked them if I could also take a part. Because yeah, I have something to say to you. And here I am. On the whole, my inspiration to prepare this text comes from several recurring cases of confusion when companies were choosing the solution. In my experience, there have been at least 4 examples where the finance department of different companies seriously considering implementing a BI system, as their main planning and forecasting tool. Additionally, I recall a case from my time at a Big Four company where a partner requested that I hold a meeting for their client to explain why they should engage our services for CPM implementation when they already had a functioning BI system. By the way, a reverse situation also cropped up. Not long ago, one CIO was interested in the possibility and feasibility of building a company-wide BI system using the built-in visualization of CPM solution. I admit that my colleagues, experts in these fields, I see them in the chat, and I know that they are experts, might find these such ideas weird. And to a large extent, I agree with them. However, firstly, I'm aware of decent solutions on the market that after a few significant adjustments, position themselves as a planning system, not a EPM or CPM system, it's much higher, but a planning system, yeah. Secondly, I've seen operational scenarios with some limitation indeed, where CPM gathers data from other IT system within the company and provides analytical BI reports for users. Before going further, you would probably expect me to give definitions for each class of systems. Evgeny said a lot about CPM. I don't think that it requires any definition. In general, I've chosen not to do so. Yeah, there are several reasons for this. And here they are. Firstly, neither CPM nor BI is strictly standard. Rather, they are attempts to classify certain types of business platforms. Moreover, in tough competition, vendors often extend their products beyond standard definition as they develop and enhance them. Secondly, I believe that vague definitions are among the reasons of confusion between CPM and BI. I don't deny that that providing a concise yet clear definition is quite a challenge. By now, these systems have gained plenty of diverse functionality. They can solve tasks from related domains. Moreover, the platforms of leading vendors can greatly differ in scope and capabilities. Any mention at least some of them. I'd like to point out that the authors of articles like CPM versus BI something .. tend to favor definitions from Gartner. Evgeny also referenced their analysis today. Overall, it seems to me that Gartner's YEP offers quite decent definitions, with one exception in their glossary, where they mention that business intelligence solutions include areas such as corporate performance management and analytics. And this is a confusion statement I'm speaking about. Here we come to the reason for modeling in using CPM and BI. When preparing the article, which I mentioned, I read numerous works, articles by other authors on a similar topic. I noticed that often these materials contained a lot of marketing and not such as substance. For instance, overview frequently mentioned benefits like decision making, performance analysis, analytics, data insight, data exploration, reporting, and so on. I've noticed that some attributed these concepts solely to a specific class of system, while others claimed the benefits apply to both classes, but with different approaches. After reading such materials or articles, you might truly get the impression that these classes of systems are very close or even interchangeable. The second reason for the confusion lies in the fact that both sets of software solutions include graphical dashboards and interactive chats. When promoting their products, whether BI or CPM, vendors will no doubt showcase examples of visually appealing dashboards because they are highly marketable. The variety of chats and promotional materials create a false impression among end users that both systems perform similar functions. I've seen several examples where CFOs from different companies deliberated on establishing their budgeting process using Power BI, for example, because the demonstrated visualizations and data drill down completely fulfill their budget reporting needs. They sometimes forgot that budgeting and planning entail much more than just reporting. Now, again, can you please scroll down, move on to the next slide? Yep. So we have no time and a lot of to say. So I have at least 10 points to compare between CPM and BI, and you see very limited time for them. Each of the points deserves individual attention and cannot be fully explored in two or three sentences. As a result, I've opted to focus on discussing only one, but particularly intriguing point today. The rest I will describe in the upcoming article, which I'll publish soon. And if there is interest, we could potentially hold a separate webinar on this topic. You are welcome to read the article on my LinkedIn or my blog. So, yeah, a lot of comments in chat, I see. Hope that our guests can wait for the answers. Today, I will be sharing insights about data entry. It's on the surface, and yet it's often overlooked. As I mentioned earlier, in my experience, there have been several cases where the decision makers, while comparing platforms, omitted the obvious point about data entry capacity. Yeah, that's are really cases, and when we discussed it with Evgeny, he mentioned that he had these cases too. Much attention is always directed towards the calculating system capabilities, as well as reports, as well as supported interfaces for integration with external systems. However, it's difficult to imagine a budgeting model solely built on data imported from external sources, and there are no metrics manually entered into the system. We enter data into planning system through input forms. These forms can either consist entirely of manually entered metrics or include partially calculated and partially input metrics. Only when a form does not contain a single manually entered metrics, we can call it a report. Now, let's circle back to the characteristics of CPM and BI systems. While CPM cannot do without advanced data entry functionality, the BI, in primary reporting and analytical systems, can do very well without it. I'm not saying that BI system totally lack data entry capabilities. They do exist, but typically they are either quite limited or use third-party plugins or Excel write-back extensions and so on. Sometimes these add-ons are suitable for extensive data input. Yeah, true, I saw them, but usually they come with an additional cost, sometimes quite high cost. On the other hand, CPM systems are inherently designed to make data entry as user-friendly as possible. Many CPM vendors offer several ways to implement input forms. For example, they provide visuals that can be loaded into a browser or form realized through Excel add-ins. So we're out of time. That's it from me in this webinar. Once again, I'm going to place the article soon and cover more points here. And now back to you, Evgeny.
Okay, thank you very much, Alexei. Thank you very much. It was very interesting, and I'm very intrigued to read through your article future. And so I will move to the conclusion. Just a second. Yes. And to be short, I will skip some conclusions, but still I should mention that, first of all, though the development of CPM systems has been significant through the past 10 years, for example, or through the past 20 years even, but it still has a long way to go. And the technical side of the systems is still not perfect. And in selection of CPM systems, you should, of course, still conduct stress testing for your tasks and consider the performance under multi-user use of the systems. The key priority for the implementation of this, the key to successful implementation is the, as demonstrated by practice, is a first lies in the selecting the system based on your own priorities, selecting the tasks that should be vital for the organization. When automated, they should lead to the reduction of the time spent on some work and the automation of processes. So this should be your priority, to select the most vital area for the automation by CPM system. I have some experience with one of the attendees on this webinar. They have been selecting the system for their financial consolidation, but then they have, I think now, for now, landed on one of the areas of the financial accounting, I mean the lease accounting. The attendees know who I'm speaking about. So you should select the specific area. Then what else? I should mention that analysis and the depth of analysis is the key to the competitiveness on the current market. But at the same time, the cost of the CPM can be the entry barrier in some industries. And if you have successfully implemented the system, it can create a value for you and divide you from the competitors. I think that this is mostly it. And I should also mention some additional information that we will send to you with this presentation. First of all, the presentation itself. Then the link to the article at LinkedIn. Then I have collected the archive of the Gartner Magic Quadrants, which can be which have been included into this presentation. And of course, we should also notify you when the Alexei's article will be issued and about the upcoming webinar when it happens. Thank you very much. Varun, I give a word to you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much, everyone. If some of you have a little bit of time left, maybe Yevgeny can stop sharing the screen. You can switch on your videos. We normally do a photo before ending a webinar, just to put onto our LinkedIn account, and you can put onto your LinkedIn accounts as well or other places. You know, so if any of you can stay for a minute longer, then you can just switch on your cameras and we can do a quick photo before we send, before we close out. Sorry, I know we've exceeded a little bit of the time limit. So I'll be quick. Okay, there you go. There's one more. If I get just one more, then we can just take a short shot. Okay, perfect. Excellent. Thank you so much, everyone, for switching on your videos. Thank you so much for your time today, and we look forward to meeting you on our next webinar. Thank you, Yevgeny and Alexei, for the insightful session.